I read A Brief History of Everyone Who Ever Lived by Adam Rutherford. This book's central idea is that genetics is a complicated science. One gene does not determine who you are. It is a mixture of hundreds of different genes, and the possibilities are endless. Dozens or hundreds of genes can be involved, each with small cumulative effects, and all migrated by the world in which we live, as said by Rutherford on 301. I thought an interesting example of this was the MAOA gene, or warrior gene, one that has its own misconceptions. Rutherford explains that this specific gene, although possibly related to violent tendencies, does not explain why someone commits murder, contrary to popular belief. Are we slaves or masters of our genes? We are neither, and it's a dumb, simplistic question, Rutherford explains on page 319. This book directly relates to the 7th grade science curriculum when it references the use of Punnett squares in determining the possibility that someone will have, say, blue eyes. It also relates to the 9th grade topics of genotype and phenotype, or what genes you have and how they represent themselves. It references these constantly throughout the book and explanations of how genes work. Although genes don't determine who you are, there are some diseases that show a direct correlation to certain genes. Take, for example, cystic fibrosis and the gene CFTR. I think it's significant when Rutherford explains this on page 291. We've known for decades that CF is a genetic disease, passed through families in a very predictable way, and since the 1980s, the gene responsible was identified as CFTR. When it is short, as in most CF patients, or otherwise broken, lung function is severely curtailed. This explains how an incorrectly formatted gene causes the disease.
Personally, I think one of the coolest aspects of this book is how it relates science with history. Being interested in both, I loved reading about how genes show politics and castes, and how we can see, based on specimens from many moons ago, what people's diets were like based on the tools they had to process food and their genes. Therefore, I would recommend this book to someone who wants a science-based history of how we came to be.
The author's purpose is to clear up any misconceptions about genes and how they work, and helps this cause through many pointed topics, such as the MAOA I referenced earlier. What I've learned from reading this book is that, although genes seem simple, they are one of the most complicated aspects of science. There are more than 20,000 letters in the human genome, which is a lot to research. I was amazed that scientists, although competitive, put their research together for the greater good. In conclusion, I loved this book because of its relation to both history and science, and would recommend it to anyone with the same interests. It clears up any misconceptions, which is helpful. Genealogy is a growing science with numerous discoveries to be made. I can't wait to see what we discover in the future. Thanks for watching!